What's happening, guys? Gary Yaman here, back at it again with a new video. Hope you're doing well, hope you're safe and happy. So let's begin right away with this video about the M1 MacBook Air that you're seeing right there, which is connected to the Apple Cinema display. But before we're going to begin, I want to tell you that this video is meant for photographers, filmmakers, and students, but also just people in general that want to have a nice laptop for a very affordable price. So let's begin right away. And this video is actually not a normal type of review video because I'm just going to show you how the laptop actually works. So without no fancy b-roll like this what you're seeing right now, show you how it works, show you how things are in real life. Let's begin right away, right? So let's switch camera positions. Here we go. All right. So as you see, everything is turned off. This is a cold start. Push the on button and then you will see how long it will take. So my laptop will take roughly around 40 seconds before it is fully turned on. And this might differ because of several apps on the background that is starting and stuff like that. But for me at least, this one starts up in roughly 40 seconds. That is something that I didn't expect actually because of the new processor and stuff, but see, now it's up and running. Meet baby Groot, guys. So as I mentioned, I do have a external mouse, but of course you can use the trackpad and just use it like that if you want to. But just for this demonstration purposes, we're gonna do this a little bit differently. It might be a little bit too dark right now, but you know, as I mentioned, we're gonna open some apps. So let's open up Lightroom. And with Lightroom, you see, camera starts to focus really weirdly right now because it doesn't know where to focus on. As you see here, this is the thumbnail of this video. Let's check out some different kind of photos. Let's see, maybe of a cat with a hat. A cat with a hat, guys. Looks like I already edited this one. So let's begin it from, let's start from the beginning. You see here, just showing you how things are working. Works perfectly fine. Little preset, automatic, maybe a little brighter, and then an automatic straightening type of stuff. Something like that. Not the best picture in the world, but just for demonstration purposes, it works pretty fine, right? So Lightroom works pretty fast. Let's export it to, let's export it here. Now, how long does that take? You can see it here, up, left bottom, or left bottom, left up, upper left, guys. So that worked perfectly fine. And then here we got some different kind of photos. This is DJI mini photos. You can, so it works really well like this. Up. Right, so Lightroom seems to be working pretty fast. Not the fastest in the world, but still, for those type of light editing stuff, it works perfectly fine. Now we're going to move to Luminar, and Luminar is a application that I use to enhance the JPEG files that I've edited, or the JPEG files, the photos that I've edited with Lightroom. So this was the picture that I exported from Lightroom. Then what you will see here with Luminar, you got the different presets, and you see there is a little bit of lag, like tiny amount of lag, still quite instant. But still works pretty fine, right? Let's add a little bit of strange things to it. Let's add a little bit of sun on the right side of this cat. Something like this, maybe. Does this look okay? I think so. Let's export this one as well. Let's give it a name. Cat with hat. And I'm gonna put it here. Save like this, and it will export it. and it's done. So it's quite fast, but not like super ultra fast whatsoever. Let's check out the final result. Cat with hat. Here it is. Looks pretty good, right? And also I like the screen, by the way, of this M1 MacBook Air. It's not a pro screen. So the pro version has a better screen, but still this works pretty well. For this kind of price point, right? So below the 1,000 euros or 1,000 bucks, this is really a good thing. So DaVinci Resolve video editing. Let's edit some videos. This, by the way, is a 1080p timeline, as you see here, because you know this is still the base model. I'm not sure if I mentioned that, by the way. I don't think I've mentioned that, but this is the base model, guys. So without no extra stuff and fluff, just the cheapest M1 MacBook Air that you can buy. And let's open up some files. So I've prepared a couple of files, right? So I've got here a DJI drone file. I've got here two Sony A7 III files. One is 4K and one is 1080p. And here a GoPro file. Right. So as you see here, by the way, this is DaVinci Resolve 17.3. Just showing you how stuff are working, right? So let's check out if you can just scrub to it. A little bit of lag. Still. Works perfectly fine. I'm going to turn down the sound just a little bit. A little bit too loud, guys. And so this one, the first clip, what you see on right here, is it, by the way, quite sharp or very soft? I cannot see it. Seems to be okay, I guess. I hope so. I really hope that this is sharp enough for you guys to see anything on it. So this is the 4K 25 frames per second file from my Sony A7 III. I'm gonna put a little LUT on it. And this one's a 1080p 100 frames per second. And this one is the DJI drone. And this is a GoPro footage. So as you see, it's not the smoothest thing in the world, but still works perfectly fine. Let's change the 100 frames per second to 25 frames per second. And then you'll get some nice slow motion, right? Something like this. Looks okay, just for demonstration purposes. As you see, it just works, right? And I think that is the main like storyline of this video. Things are just working perfectly fine. So the version, the MacBook that I had before, this one is the MacBook Pro 2017, and that one just gonna take care of this. And this looks like I'm doing this very easily. This is me, by the way, jumping into the pool. This is a GoPro clip. We can also gonna remove the audio. We can also just change this, then you can see me jumping into the water. All right, so we got here in total a 28 second clip, and just going to render this, guys, real quickly. Let's see, put it here, give it the name demo. Let's change it to mp4 and then 4k, just like that. That's it. So 28 seconds with 4K clips, 1080p, slow motion, LUTs applied. Let's go. Real life, full time. And as you see, it just blasts through the footage like crazy, right? So if you really like those like very lightweight type of editing, then it's done in 16 seconds. 28 seconds clip. rendered in 16 seconds. And I think, guys, that is truly amazing, man. That's truly amazing. So as you see, photo editing, video editing works perfectly fine. What about if you are a student and you happen to use Microsoft Word, right? I still use Microsoft Word from time to time just to write down things, write some YouTube ideas and stuff. I see that this is now in dark mode, but anyways, it should be pretty fine, right? So by the way, let's type on the MacBook itself. The typing experience is pretty good. Let's enlarge that. I don't know what the shortcut is for making it larger. The typing experience is pretty good, right? So we can just copy this and just paste everything. 31 pages and we're good to go. Works pretty fast. Don't want to save it. What else do we got? We got Excel, of course. If you're a student, there is a huge chance that you're working with Excel. And if you got a business, then you definitely have Excel. Let's do some dumb stuff. One, and it goes automatically to one. All right, I didn't expect that. Let's do it like this, This is a very weird demonstration, by the way, guys, but I just wanted to show you that things are working perfectly fine if you got a M1 MacBook Air. So it's still the 8 gigs of RAM. It is not hot at all, it's just very cold still. Safari, if you are somebody that likes to work with Safari, go ahead and work with it. It is fast, it is smooth. But for me personally, I like to use Google Chrome, because even though we got here a iPhone, we also got here a Xiaomi phone. We got a lot of stuff going on here in this household, but I'm not committed to just one ecosystem, right? So anyways, Google Chrome works perfectly fine. Open up extra stuff and more stuff here and here. And you see, it works really, really fast, right? What else? What else? Just random stuff. Things are working pretty, pretty fast. And I really like it. Still very silent. You don't hear any fan noises or stuff like that. You know, I think that's really cool. Let's check out some of my own videos. Of course, we got some commercials. So, this is our little cat. You can play in 4K if you really want to. So as you see here, it is really good, right? It just works perfectly fine. So if you're still hesitating on this M1 MacBook Air, you should not hesitate at all. Just get the base model if you don't want to spend a lot of money, and then you will be very happy with it. If you are a photographer, video editor, content creator, you are a student, or just is in the need of a new laptop, go ahead and buy the M1 MacBook Air. You'll be very happy with it. All right, so that's about it. Thank you again, guys, for watching. Subscribe to the channel if not already. Like the video, comment down below, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. As always, stay safe and stay healthy.